Tonight on NewsWatch, the president's Asia trip, why it's important to the U.S. and world, and why China isn't on the agenda. Plus, growing prices at the grocery store and gas pump. Can you expect relief for your pocketbook anytime soon? And heaven is for real is a hit box office hit, but do some Christians disagree with its message? All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. Good evening, I'm Lori Johnson. President Obama is on his way to Asia, where he has some fence mending to do. Starting in Japan, the president will work to reassure America's Asia allies that the U.S. is committed to the region both economically and militarily. The president has promised a U.S. pivot on policy in Asia, but still needs to close the deal on its Trans-Pacific partnership. The U.S. has increased regional military deployments, but after watching Russia annex Crimea, some of America's Asian allies wonder if the U.S. is capable of backing them up against potential Chinese aggressions. After an official state visit to Japan, the president will become the first president since Lyndon Johnson to visit Malaysia. He's also visiting South Korea and the Philippines. The president is not making any stops in China. Joining us now is Gordon Chang. He lived and worked in China for two decades and is an author and a contributor at Forbes.com. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you so much.
Well, what do you think the purpose of this trip is?
It really is to reassure our friends and allies in East Asia. They've been unnerved by the indecisive diplomacy of the White House, especially in connection with Syria and now, of course, Ukraine. So the idea is that we are going there, we're going to talk to our allies, and we're going to put them at the top of the list.
Well, it's very interesting that the president is skipping China, the biggest player in East Asia. Why do you think he's doing that?
Well, there's been too much Chinese diplomacy up to now. And because we have said that they are at the center of the international system, we are feeding their already inflated notions of self-importance. That is counterproductive. As the Chinese think they're important, they become more provocative and belligerent and have been causing trouble in the region, especially in the last 2 years.
Well, do you think our allies in the region have cause to be worried about China?
Well, they do have cause to be worried because Beijing believes that China should be bigger than it is today. And so they are causing friction in an arc of nations from India in the south to South Korea in the north. And of course, they're trying to close off this international water of the South China Sea, which they believe is an internal Chinese lake. And that brings us into play, because if the United States has had any consistent foreign policy over the course of two centuries, it has been the defense of freedom of navigation. And China is threatening that.
What do you think the U.S. can do to counter China's new aggression?
Well, there are a couple of things that we need to do right away. One of them is we need to be very clear in public as well as in private that the United States will defend its allies and friends in East Asia, and that we will be the guarantor of security, and that the Chinese have to act within norms. Also, this Trans-Pacific Partnership, which is a proposed free trade deal between the United States and about 11 nations in the region, is very important because it'll tie them to us rather than to China. So this is a very important part of the pivot, which is this rebalancing of American attention to East Asia.
Well, you mentioned Syria and Ukraine. Do you think our allies trust the Obama administration to defend them against China if necessary?
Certainly, the issue of Syria really got to both Tokyo and Seoul, because President Obama announced that he wanted to use military force, but that he first had to go to get congressional approval. And that led many people in the region with defense treaties with the United States wondering whether if China attacked them, President Obama would have to go to Congress in order to honor our defense treaties.
All right, Gordon Chang, thanks for your insights and for joining us today.
Thank you.
And for the complete interview with Gordon, go to our website, cbnnews.com. Before heading to Asia, President Obama visits the scene of the deadly mudslide near Oso, Washington. More than three dozen people died. And while the search for bodies is over, CBN's David Brody reports there are still people looking for answers.
Along Route 530, the way to the devastating mudslide is lined with signs, Oso Strong, and God bless Oso, messages of love along a road that has caused so much pain. This road on 530 is going to be closed for a few months, but while this road is closed, there are now open roads to people's hearts because this tragedy has really given pastors an opportunity in this area to talk to people about Jesus. Pastor Michael Duncan in nearby Darrington is one of those spreading the word. He and his wife share a unique perspective. They missed the mudslide by just 2 minutes.
It's hard to talk about. Because I don't think I deserve to be the man that was saved by 2 minutes.
Yet here he is, alive and trying to make the most of it.
We don't have days left. I had 2 minutes, is all I had. And there were people that died that I knew that didn't have that time. They don't have the rest of the year to get saved. They had that day.
Amanda Scorions almost joined the dead. Her home slid 600 feet before stopping.
I know that God was with us because as it was going, I cried out to him and I said, please save us.
But what about those not saved? Many ask, where was God for them? Pastor Duncan explains it this way.
Well, God is in the middle of all of this. He's right in the middle of it all. The Bible says that God brings the day of disaster as well as the day of blessing. That God is not necessarily, we don't charge God with a fault, that he's not wrong in letting these things happen. There's a day appointed for everybody, and nobody gets to that day without God's permission. That appointed day belongs to God. Life and death are in his hands.
And that's a theme preached by pastors up here. Many are listening and seeking help.
And about 32 have come in this last week or so just for prayer and to find out more about comfort. And so it's been a great opportunity to meet new people and share with them the love and power of Christ.
This area of the Pacific Northwest needs to hear about Jesus. Statistics show it has the least amount of Bible-believing Christians in the country.
It is a highly unchurched area, perhaps in the top five unchurched areas of the United States. And so there's a real opportunity now for the church or churches to rise up and show the love of God.
And some are getting closer to God through this ordeal. Pastor Duncan told us about a woman who lost a family member.
She's not saved yet that I believe. I don't think she is. But she is inquiring about God now where she wouldn't talk about God at all. She wants to know about eternal things. Is my loved one with God in heaven? What's happened? What comes next? And those are the questions that will lead her to a relationship with Christ.
The pain will linger for some time in this majestic area of the country, but a majestic God is making his presence felt during a time of great agony and suffering. David Brody, CBN News, in Oso, Washington.
Violent clashes developed in East Ukraine just hours after Vice President Biden left Kiev. Two bodies abducted by pro-Russian insurgents were found, and a military aircraft was fired upon. Biden announced during his visit that the U.S. will provide Ukraine with $50 million to help with reforms. He was there to reinforce the international agreement made last week between the fighting countries. He told Moscow to encourage the pro-Russian separatists in eastern Ukraine to leave government buildings and accept amnesty. Russia denies allegations they instigated the troubles in eastern Ukraine. People are still speaking out for and against the Keystone pipeline, even though the State Department delayed a decision on its construction. The latest, a protest by the Cowboy and Indian Alliance. They join others accusing the White House of playing politics in an election year. CBN's Caitlin Burke reports.
The Cowboy and Indian Alliance gathered on the Mall in Washington to bring their message to the president. They don't want the Keystone Pipeline and the harm they believe it will bring to their land.
The pipeline is going to contaminate the largest freshwater aquifer in North America, which is the Oglala Aquifer. So the pipeline will break. And once it does, it's going to leak in and contaminate all of our freshwater to drink.
The State Department says the latest delay is due to an ongoing court case over the pipeline. But both supporters and opponents say it's actually a case of politics trumping policy. If the pipeline is approved ahead of midterm elections, it could impact Democrats' campaign cash flow. It also keeps liberal environmentalists happy, while still allowing some Democrats to say they support the pipeline and the jobs it would create. The chair of the Democratic National Committee denies using the pipeline to help Democrats keep control of the Senate.
The decision over the Keystone pipeline is complex, and it's one that has to be examined very carefully. It affects multiple states. What's also true is that incumbent senators like Mary Landrieu understand the issues that are important on the ground in their state to their constituents.
The Keystone pipeline would carry crude oil from the Alberta oil sands in Canada to Gulf Coast refineries. And supporters are quick to remind groups like Cowboys and Indians that several State Department reviews have already concluded it would be safe and would allow America to get more oil close to home. Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
Angry Palestinians are waging a smear campaign against one of their own. It comes after a government minister called Jewish blood precious, according to the Gatestone Institute report, referring to the shooting death of a Jewish policeman in front of his family last week before Passover. Palestinian Religious Affairs Minister Mahmoud Al-Habash said, "We reject all forms of violence, whether they be directed against Israelis or Palestinians. Palestinian blood is like Israeli blood. It is human blood and precious, and no one wants anyone killed." Al-Habash's family disowned him. One militant group demanded an apology, and the Palestinian Authority has not condemned the attack. The Jewish policeman, his wife, and 9-year-old son were on their way to a Passover Seder. He was killed. His wife and son were wounded. A message of light from a place of darkness. Pastor Saeed Abedini sends an Easter message from his hospital bed in Iran, where he's serving an 8-year sentence for his faith. Part of his message reads, "Sometimes we want to experience the glory and resurrection with Jesus without experiencing death with him. We do not realize that unless we pass through the path of death with Christ, we are not able to experience resurrection with Christ." He signed the message, "Prisoner of darkness in Iran, but free for the kingdom and light." Coming up, rising prices are cutting into budgets everywhere. What's fueling high prices at the pump and at grocery stores?
I have a son who's extremely smart and sensitive. He went to heaven. I came back.
One true story has become a worldwide sensation.
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Now, Heaven is for Real is a profoundly beautiful movie.
They don't read me, do they?
Some people might be afraid to believe.
That will help many to believe.
Is heaven a hope or as real as the earth and sky?
A perfect family film. Heaven is for Real. Rated PG.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need. Just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right. You could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
I have a son who's extremely smart and sensitive. He went to heaven. I came back.
One true story has become a worldwide sensation.
You saw heaven?
It's beautiful.
Now, Heaven is for Real is a profoundly beautiful movie.
They don't read me, do they?
Some people might be afraid to believe.
That will help many to believe.
Is heaven a hope or as real as the earth and sky?
A perfect family film. Heaven is for Real. Rated PG.
Democrats are being advised not to talk about an economic recovery in their election campaigns. The party's leading political strategists call the topic a political loser. In head-to-head polling, Republicans win the issue simply by pointing out the Obama administration has failed to get the economy moving in its 6 years in office. Food prices jumped last month, according to the latest government reports, and that's on top of rising gas prices. As CBN's Heather Sells reports, it's causing many families to tighten their family budget.
Gakima Robinson likes to cook bacon for her kids, especially on important test days, but she hasn't bought much lately.
That pack here used to be maybe about $5 or $6, now it's $10 almost.
Rising food prices are also putting a dent into what used to be a profitable breakfast business at Norma's Cafe.
We're looking at record prices in anything from beef to bacon to orange juice, eggs.
Analysts say bad weather is putting the pressure on these food prices. It includes a record-setting drought in California, Mexico, and Brazil.
And believe it or not, tensions between Ukraine and Russia are also contributing. That's because Ukraine exports substantial amounts of corn, wheat, and sunflower oil. The Consumer Price Index, released last Tuesday, shows food prices rising 0.4% in March. The biggest increases came from eggs, milk, butter, oranges, pork, ground beef, and poultry. The U.S. Department of Ag is predicting food prices will rise between 2.5% and 3.5% this year, but many analysts say it could be worse. On top of that, pain at the pump is also hitting many consumers. The national average is up to $3.69 a gallon for gas, up nearly 10 cents in the last 2 weeks, and up by 4% from a year ago.
I'm not happy about it because I travel an hour to work.
Analysts say U.S. refiners are shipping more gas to other countries, creating more global competition for U.S.-produced fuel. For consumers, that means prices might not come down anytime soon. And that's tough news for many Americans, eager to hit the road this summer after being cooped up during a record-setting winter. Heather Sells, CBN News.
Hello? Is this thing on? Hey, kids, do you love games? And do you love discovering things?
Yeah!
Well, do you?
Yeah!
Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes and Google Play now.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. If you are on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. Call the Health Hotline right now for details, toll-free. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to take your call. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. You may be eligible to receive these items and more at little or no cost to you as well. Call right now for details, toll-free.
Operators are standing by. Call 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143. Again, 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
China will be the world's largest Christian nation in 15 years, according to a report from a UK's The Telegraph newspaper. A leading expert says it will happen in less than a generation. Right now, there are about 1.3 billion people living in the country, and in 2010, 58 million of them were Protestants. The report shows that number should jump to 160 million by 2025. And by 2030, China's total Christian population, including Catholics, will hit 247 million. Officially, the People's Republic of China is still an atheist country, but the government allows official churches to meet, and there is a growing underground church movement that cannot be contained. Well, decades ago, most Christians in China lived in the countryside, but now that's changing as young professionals are bringing faith to the big cities like Beijing and Shanghai. George Thomas has that story from Beijing.
It's Wednesday, just after 7 p.m. In an apartment not too far from the city center, a group of men and women in their late 20s discuss how to thrive in their rapidly changing nation. All are members of China's new privileged class, highly educated, cosmopolitan, middle or even upper class of urban professionals. And they're all Christians.
We've never had it so good in China today. But there's more to life than just money and materialism.
Worship God, worship heaven.
Jia Litian works for one of Beijing's largest tour operators. Like young urban professionals in other parts of the world, he and his peers live in high-rise apartment buildings. They own a car, sometimes two. They are tech-savvy, they travel, they have money to spend. But the pressure to succeed and thrive is fierce.
The competition for jobs in the big cities is intense. Status is everything. How much you make, how big is your apartment, what kind of car you drive. This is what people focus on.
The government makes it possible for us to earn money and have a good life, but how do we handle all these pressures? The government doesn't have answers for this.
And it is in this rapidly changing society that religion, especially Christianity, finds itself filling a spiritual void.
I'm a different person today.
23-year-old Zhe Kun joins the growing rank of those in the cities who are embracing Christianity in record numbers.
The last couple of years have been difficult for me. I have struggled professionally and personally. But then someone introduced me to Jesus, and now I have a different outlook on my life.
This is music to the ears of Jude's pastor.
God called me to start a church to reach these young people with the gospel.
Jin Tiangming leads Shuang, one of the largest unregistered, sometimes called underground, churches in Beijing. A graduate of China's most prestigious university, Jin's church began 18 years ago with 10 people. Now, close to 1,000 attend his weekly service.
The majority of them have graduated from college and work in the city. We have lawyers, professors, doctors, business people.
He says similar gatherings are springing up in other big cities, attracting the white-collar working world.
They are looking for ways to handle the dramatic changes in China, and they're finding answers in Christianity.
Back at the apartment, Jia Litian helps run a Bible study for new converts in the city. He says this is the new face of Christianity in China. Such believers are part of what some are calling China's third church.
But Peter,
not his real name, has worked with China's underground churches for decades. CBN News agreed to conceal his identity to protect him.
They're called the third church because they're very different than what used to be the only two real kinds of churches in China, which were the registered church, registered with the government, and then the unregistered churches, usually called house churches, which thrived in the countryside in the 70s and 80s. But then after the 1989 demonstrations, these urban, educated, well-to-do Christians started forming urban churches.
And while Christianity continues to grow in China's countryside, it is here, in the big cities like Beijing, that experts say the church is growing the fastest.
Whereas the rural church was not able to have an impact on society as a whole, the third church in the cities is able to do that because they're comprised of leaders who can have an impact. Businessmen, government officials, professors, leaders in engineering, every aspect of life.
Pastor Jin's congregation is technically an illegal gathering. You see, he hasn't registered his church with the government, nor is it part of any of the state-sanctioned churches. But rather than hide from authorities, Jin and others who lead such congregations in the big cities want to work with the government officials. But let's be clear, the Chinese government maintains a tight grip on religion. Torture, arrests, imprisonment, and beatings of Christians are still practiced, yet the authorities in recent years have made positive overtures toward leaders of the house church, especially those in the urban areas.
The church in China is growing, and Christianity is becoming more and more a part of mainstream society. The authorities know this, and they're showing a willingness to work with us.
A gesture welcomed by these young believers as they use faith to navigate the opportunities and challenges of China today. George Thomas, CBN News, Beijing.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. If you are on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. Call the Health Hotline right now for details, toll-free. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to take your call. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. You may be eligible to receive these items and more at little or no cost to you as well. Call right now for details, toll-free.
Operators are standing by. Call 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143. Again, 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need, just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions, just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card, just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
The movie Heaven is for Real opened just before Easter and quickly became a box office smash. It's based on the true story of a little boy's near-death experience and his glimpse into heaven. It grossed $29 million in its first week alone. And while the movie is a hit, there are skeptics, including well-known pastor John MacArthur.
Well, I'm convinced that the entire movie and the book is a hoax from start to finish. It has nothing to do with Christianity. It has nothing to do with the Bible.
This film is a great opportunity to bring in the margin of our community who really doesn't normally talk about faith or the afterlife, and you walk away inspired to believe that all things are possible.
Whatever your take on near-death experiences may be, Heaven is for Real is sparking discussion about what happens after death, and many Christians say that's a good thing. One little boy's story giving people hope and bolstering their faith. That's all the time we have for this edition of NewsWatch. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again tomorrow.